Hello dear students, once again a very warm welcome to these virtual classes where we are discussing some poems and texts that are prescribed in your first year syllabus. Today we are going to study a very popular and a beautiful song, Song of Radha, the Milkmaid, which is written by Sarojini Naidu. Dear friends, this poem basically based on a very popular incident or very popular episode of Indian mythology, that is romantic relationship between Lord Krishna and Radha. Okay, a brief background to this poem. We have already discussed about Sarojini Naidu in the earlier poem, the Indian weavers, and we have seen that how she included Indian mythology, Indian scenes, Indian settings in her poetry. Similarly, this poem, which is taken from the collection The Bird of Time. The Bird of Time is considered to be written as the second phase of her poetry. The second phase of Sarojini's poetry is basically known for her inclusion of folk songs. I hope you all understand what do we mean by this term, folk songs. In fact, this very poem, Song of Radha, is from the section Folk Songs of India. Folk song, dear student, or in Hindi, we say it Lok Geet. They are part and parcel of the culture of that particular area. For example, in Northern India, we have different sort of folk songs associated with different festivals, ceremonies, celebrations, mythology, festivals. Similarly, in Southern India, we have different type of folk songs. These folk songs are indicators. Ye kis cheez ka sanket hote hain? How rich the heritage, how particular festival or particular occasion is celebrated. So, if we talk about this particular poem, we all know about Radha. Radha in Hindu mythology is considered as the beloved of God Krishna during the period of his life when he lived among cowherds of Vrindavan. हम सभी लॉर्ड कृष्ण, भगवान कृष्ण और राधा का जो उत्तम प्रेम प्रसंग है उसके बारे में जानते हैं. हाउ लॉर्ड कृष्ण हु वाज एन अवतार ऑफ विष्णु, उनके किस तरह से जो वृंदावन के अंदर उनका जो प्रारंभिक जीवन था, उस समय राधा उनकी एक संगिनी, उनकी एक सखा, उनकी एक फ्रेंड, उनकी एक रोमांटिक वी कैन से प्लेमेट के रूप में जानी जाती है. She has a permanent place in devotional or we can say bhakti movement of India. In devotional religion, she represents the longing of the human soul for God. It is very important. In all type of Indian mythology, we use many characters, but these characters always represents a longing. What is the meaning of longing? It's a beautiful word. Longing means desire or Ichha of the human soul for God. Similarly, in the Bhakti movement, ek movement tha mid 15th and 16th century mein, in which many poets like Surdas, like Rai Das and Ras Khan, they were writing poems especially related with वैष्णविज्म, जिसके अंदर द विमेन राधा शी सिंबलाइजेज द ह्यूमन सोल एंड मेल कृष्ण ही सिंबलाइजेज द डिवाइन. सो द पेयर ऑफ राधा एंड कृष्ण दे रिप्रेजेंट द हार्मोनियस, द हार्मनी और द डिवाइन यूनियन बिटवीन सोल एंड डिवाइन, और इन अदर वर्ड्स आत्मा एंड परमात्मा. ओके, विद दिस बैकग्राउंड आई होप यू ऑल आर रेडी टू रीड दिस ब्यूटिफुल पोएम. This poem begins, it is basically a poem in three stanzas, and all three stanzas follow a similar pattern. Inka structure jo hai, almost it is similar. So we begin this poem with this stanza in which I here stands for Radha herself. And she says, I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. How softly the heifer was lying. I wanted to cry, who will buy these curds that are white as the clouds in the sky? When the breezes of Shravan are blowing, but my heart was so full of your beauty, beloved, they laughed as I cried without knowing. Govinda, 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 how softly the river was flowing. Okay, in the very first stanza, we can see Radha as an ordinary milkmaid. She is taking her curds. It's a daily routine. Apne curds ko Mathura fair to sell the curds. And she observes the beautiful environment and she sees the heifers were lowing. Lowing, their typical sound. What is lowing? This lowing is the sound made by the heifers. Heifers, the babies of cow. Okay. I wanted to cry. Who will buy these curds? She is carrying pots of curds that are white as the clouds in the sky. We can easily see that this white as the cloud is an example of simile. The curds are compared with clouds basically for two reasons. One is the color, which itself is given white. Okay. And the second one is fluffiness. Jis tarah se clouds hote hain, they appear to be quite fluffy. Similarly, jo curd hai, that is also fluffy. Lekin cloudy nahi. Which clouds? When the breezes of Shravan are blowing. Now, instead of her trade cry, what is a trade cry? Trade cry, jitne bhi vendors hote hain, jitne bhi sellers hote hain, when they want to sell the product, they make a particular cry. Or us cry ko, jaise for example, dahi ke liye jo cry honi chahiye. Instead of making that trade cry, she is totally lost in the thoughts of her beloved Lord Krishna. So she cries, Govinda, 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 Govinda. Samjhe aap? She wants to speak, she wants to sell the curds, she wants to attract the attention of the passerbys, she wants to show them that superior quality of her curds, but she is not able to do so. Why? Because as soon as she opens her mouth, the thoughts which are basically with which she is totally filled, they come in the form of these beautiful words. Govind, 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 Govind. Or in other words, we can say she is totally lost. She is totally lost and not able to deal in the practical world. Obviously, it becomes the reason for the passerbys to laugh at her. They laugh at her because they expect her. Woh usse umeed kar rahe hain that as she has come to sell her curds, she would speak about the quality of her curds. But instead of that, she is just chanting. You can remember this word, which is very good and apt one for this particular name. Chanting. Sanskrit ke andar jis tarah se hum mantrochar kehte hain, chanting is taking a name again and again. So she is chanting this name, Govind, 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 Govind. How softly the river was flowing. Once again, she points out this particular line we will see in the coming stanzas. This works as a uniting line. ये सारे stanzas को connect करती है. तो ये था first stanza in which Radha presents the first scene of the day when she is taking her curds to the market to sell, but she becomes a butt of laughter. The buyers mock her, the buyers laugh at her because she is not interested in selling the curd, but rather she is chanting the name of her beloved. We come to the next stanza. She says, I cant my pots to the Mathura tide. How gaily the rows were rowing. My comrades called, ho, let's dance, let's sing, and wear saffron garments to welcome the spring, and pluck the new buds that are blowing. But my heart was so full of your music, beloved, they mocked when I cried without knowing, Govind, 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 how gaily the river was flowing. Now, friends, in the second scene, now the scene is that of Mathura tide. Mathura tide means, once again, the Yamuna river is mentioned here. और यमुना रिवर की जो टाइड है वेव्स है वो है एंड द रोर्स आवर रोइंग द बोट्स आर देयर द रोमेंस आर देयर एंड यूजुअल बिजनेस इज गोइंग ऑन कॉमरेड्स कॉमरेड्स और फ्रेंड्स और प्लेमेट्स वी कैन से संगी साथी खेलने वाले साथी दे कॉल्ड हर हाउ लेट अस डांस लेट अस सिंग बिकॉज for people associated with business of selling curds and milk, morning and evening time are important and rest of the day they can do whatever they want to do. Pura time wo free hote. So they are calling her, uske playmates, they are inviting Radha to let us dance and let us sing and wear saffron garments to welcome the spring. Once again, here you can see a tradition in Indian culture. Vasant. Vasant ke liye, or in particular day, we all know very well, Vasant Panchami. They all want to welcome this beautiful season of spring. Now, the spring season, traditionally, it is associated with celebration, with joy, with dancing and singing, because earth is now once again awaking from the sleep of the winter season. The new birds, they are everywhere, the air is very fragrant, and spring is basically considered to be the season associated with the young people. So these young comrades, so these young playmates, they all invite Radha to be part of the celebration. Once again, her heart is so full of the divine music of Lord Krishna. We all know that Krishna was very fond of playing flute. And Radha is not able to hear any other music apart from this music by Krishna. And that is why she once again become an object of laughter. She is once again laughed at by her friends when she cried without knowing. Instead of singing songs, instead of enjoying with her friends, she once again recites. In the last stanza, we talk about the word chant. Here we can talk about this word recites. She recites, Govind, 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 Govind. How gaily the river was flowing. Now, देखिए बाकी stanza, it is easy to understand. There is a new device, poetic device, which we should take care of, and that device is called refrain. Now, what is a refrain? Dear students, refrain is a poetic device in which a poet repeats a particular phrase or even a complete line, even a complete line, again and again in different stanzas. It can be the first line of a stanza, it can be the last line of a stanza, it can be a middle line of a stanza, and this particular line is repeated again and again in each stanza. I hope you all know what is a stanza. A stanza is a, we can say, a pattern in which number of lines in a poem is fixed. For example, if we look at last stanza, here number of lines 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We come to our next stanza. Once again, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So, for example, we can say in this poem there are stanzas of 10 lines each. Each stanza has 10 lines. And now, you see in the last stanza, the last three lines are Govinda, Govind, Govinda, Govind. We can't say it as a complete line, but yes, it's a in poetry, it is a line. And the last line is with minute, jara sa ek variation hai. For usme tha basically how the river was flowing was the similar. Only difference was how softly the river was flowing, or is stanza ke andar how gaily the river was flowing. So, isko hum bolte hain refrain. I hope you understand. Once again, remember what is a refrain. Refrain is the repetition of a particular line or even two or three lines at a fixed place in each stanza. This is very important. Agar ek stanza mein ek se zyada bar repeat karte hain ya koi line bar bar repeat hoti hai, but at different places in the stanza. Kabhi wo stanza ki first line hai, kisi stanza mein wo second ya third line hai, then it is not a refrain, then it is called repetition. Refrain is at a fixed point, wo fixed point par honi chahiye. So we have seen two stanzas. The first stanza presents her absent-mindedness when she is about to sell her curds in the marketplace. The second stanza presents her absent-mindedness when she is with her friends and they all are playing and enjoying the spring season. But she is not able to do so because once again we find her lost in the thoughts of her beloved. Now we come to the final stanza. Once again, there are 10 lines in this stanza also, and she says, I carried my gifts to the Mathura shrine. How brightly the torches were glowing. I folded my hands at the altars to pray. O shining ones, guard us by night and by day. And loudly the conch shells were blowing. But my heart was so lost in your worship, beloved. They were wrath when I cried without knowing, Govind, 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 Govind. How brightly the river was flowing. Now, this stanza, this is evening time. So the whole day is covered. Morning time, then afternoon time, and now the evening time, late evening time. She is now at a shrine, a temple, a local temple where a local deity is worshipped. And the torches were glowing, mashal, us samay, we can't say that it is electricity. We can understand the jo temple hai, it is lighted with mashal. I folded my hands at the altars. What is altar? Altar is, jisko hum bolte hain, vedi. Okay, I folded my hands at altars to pray. O shining ones, this is prayer. Jo inverted comma jab bhi ek poem ke beech mein lagate hain, then it means the speaker is speaking directly. So Radha was describing the scene, but now she is speaking the real words, that is her prayer to the local gods. O shining ones, guard us by day, by night and by day. एंड लाउडली ड्यूरिंग दिस होल सेरेमनी, ये जो पूरी इवनिंग प्रेयर चल रही है, द कॉन्च शेल्स शंख वर ब्लोइंग, बट वंस अगेन माई हार्ट वॉज सो लॉस्ट इन योर वर्शिप. फॉर राधा देर इज नो अदर गॉड, हर ओनली ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ वर्शिप, हर ओनली वी कैन से डिजायर इज टू वर्शिप हर बिलवड लॉर्ड कृष्ण. दे वर रॉथ, दे priests, जो लोकल priests थे या फिर अदर worshippers who have come to the temple to offer their prayers, they were wrath, they were totally angry because it is almost we can say a show of defiance means she is not paying respect to the gods for whom the temple is built, but rather she is taking name of a common man. For them, Krishna is another common man. I cried without knowing, Govind, 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 Govind. How brightly the river was flowing. Once again, you can see the last three lines, Govind, 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 Govind. How brightly the river was flowing. Once again, it is a refrain. We can see the last three lines in each stanzas follow a typical structure. इन फैक्ट सिमिलर वर्ड्स, केवल जो एक माइनर चेंज है वो जो रिवर के साथ है, कभी सॉफ्टली लग रहा है, कभी गेली लग रहा है और कभी ब्राइटली लग रहा है. दीज लाइन्स आल्सो फंक्शन टू यूनाइट डिफरेंट सीन्स. जो पूरा दिन है इट कंटिन्यूस लाइक द रिवर विच कंटिन्यूस टू फ्लो. सो दिस इज ब्यूटिफुल पोएम इन दीज थ्री स्टेंजास. और तीनों जो स्टेंजा है दे हाईलाइट we can say the mental and the emotional state of Radha. In fact, Song of Radha is a very popular poem as its subject matter is one of the most loved episodes of our culture, the love story of Lord Krishna and Radha. The poem presents deep devotion of Radha for Lord Krishna as she has lost all her other senses and every time just think of her divine beloved. In fact, these stanzas are like some pictures from the daily life of Radha and how she is besotted. It may be a new word for you people, besotted. Besotted is another word we can use is obsessed or totally devoted with the memories of Govind, that she is always chanting his name as if in a reverie. Another new word for you people, reverie is in other word is a daydream, diva swapna. In the first stanza, Radha describes how as her daily routine she takes curd to sell in Mathura fair. Once in the hustle bustle of the market, she also wants to sell her curd by drawing the attention of the passers-by. She wants to cry about the superior quality of her curd, which is as foamy and white as a cloud. However, her thoughts are so full of her beloved Krishna that instead of making her trade cry, she unknowingly cries, Govind, Govind. Hearing her thus taking the name of her beloved, the buyers laugh at her condition. So this is we can say explanation of, or we can say in other words, a brief summary of the first stanza. The second scene describes the playmates of Radha singing and dancing in merriment. They ask her also to join them in the celebration to welcome the season of spring. This season is the season of festivity as the new flowers bloom and there is an atmosphere of cheerfulness. So all the friends call Radha to wear saffron cloths to welcome the season and sing and dance with them. However, once again, Radha is completely lost in the music played on flute by her beloved. She is unable to hear any other song and celebration except the music of Govinda. So once again, crying his name, she becomes a subject of laughter among her playmates. This is this summary of second stanza. The next stanza describes Radha going to a local temple in the evening to offer her prayers. rather describes the pious atmosphere of the shrine, which is lighted with lamps, and there is sound of conch blowing as everyone is offering flowers to the shrine god. Radha also, with folded hands, pray to gods to keep their blessings on her. However, once again she reveals her inner heart when she loudly takes the name of her beloved Govind instead of the name of the shrine god. She is not able to hide her deep love for Lord Krishna as she only worships him. Naturally, this makes the priests angry, but Radha is unaware of their wrath and she continues to chant the name of her soulmate Govind, Govind. Her devotion for Govind is as perennial. What is the meaning of perennial? It may be a new word for you, dear students. Perennial is everlasting, non-stop, or in easy words we can say ceaseless, non-stop, everlasting, which never ceases, as the flow of the river Yamuna. That is why she has used this line again and again in three stanzas, and she shows this devotion by chanting his name knowingly or unknowingly through her day and night. Thus, this short and beautiful lyric shows the unparalleled devotion of Radha for Lord Krishna. Krishna is not an incarnation for her. Incarnation, what we call avatar in Hindi. He is her sakha or soulmate, and he resides in her very existence. She is so much lost in the divine love of Govinda that she is detached from all the other activities of daily life. That's why she is always taking his name even when everyone mocks her for such absent-mindedness. Thus, Sarojini ji has presented one of the most celebrated episodes of Indian mythology, the divine relationship between Radha and Krishna. This is all, dear friends, for this poem. We will soon meet in another tutorial based on your syllabus. Thank you, friends.